Hey y'all, it's your favorite wedding planner, Rachel Burt Garcia, owner of As You Wish Events. And today, we're gonna talk about your burning questions about my Say Yes to the Dress experience. All right, y'all, so hopefully, if you've been here for a while, you've seen my Say Yes to the Dress experience video. I go through the whole day from start to finish, what happened, what dresses I tried on, and all about Kleinfeld and my experience there for Say Yes to the Dress. However, I get a ton of questions about what really happened behind the scenes that I really don't touch on in that video. So today, I wanted to talk to you guys about your burning questions that I always get about what really went down. So a lot of people assume that Say Yes to the Dress actually reached out to me because I'm a wedding planner, but I actually applied for the show. So what happened was I was watching The Bachelorette with my girlfriends, you know, just drinking wine as we do. She said that she had applied to be on Say Yes to the Dress and that I should apply. And I honestly had never thought about it before. So all credit goes to my friend Laura, you know who you are, who convinced me to apply for the show in the first place. And so, of course, that night we start the application process on my laptop, you know, drinking wine, watching The Bachelorette, and we realize really quickly, like, oh my gosh, this application is really long. This is not something that you can just do quickly sitting, you know, with your friends on a couch. Like, you actually have to sit down, think through the answers, and it probably took me a good 30 minutes to an hour to fill out the application, find all of the information they were asking for, and submit all of the photos as well. So once I applied, actually, I heard back very quickly. It was literally the next business day that I heard back on my application. I think they loved the fact that I was a wedding planner, getting married myself, and I think they really enjoyed that storyline. So as I was talking with casting about who all I would be able to bring, I really didn't know what to expect. And from watching the show in years past, I thought you could just bring your whole army of, you know, girls and whoever you wanted to bring. And at least for my season, that simply was not true. I hear a lot of people talking about Say Yes to the Dress and how, you know, everybody brings like 7 or 8 people with them. And it's actually kind of a point of people make fun of that on social media. But that was not my experience at all. In fact, they really limited who I was able to bring because I roll deep. I have a huge family. I have lots of friends. I wanted so many people to come on the show with me, but in reality, they made me narrow it down so significantly. And then they kind of guided me on who really could come at the end of the day. I didn't really get to make that final decision. So it ended up being my mom, of course, one of my bridesmaids and my cousin, Charlotte, and my maid of honor and best friend from high school, Macy. And so they really loved the fact that, of course, they're gonna, you know, allow me to bring my mom, and my mom, you know, is my best friend at the end of the day, and she always gives me really solid advice when it comes to any purchases that I'm making, so it was really important for me to have her there during such a milestone. Charlotte, they loved that she was spunky and sassy and had a really great fashion background, and so that's why they really were leaning towards her. And then from there, they picked Macy because Macy is kind of like my friend that tells it like it is, that is not afraid to, you know, tell us what she really thinks, and she does on the show if you have not watched it, which cracks me up every time. But that's just our relationship. So that's kind of who they guided me towards narrowing it down to. And of course, I was devastated to not be able to bring some of my other cousins who are also my bridesmaids, my aunt that lives in New York, literally right down the street from Kleinfeld. It was very hard to make that decision as far as narrowing it down. But at the end of the day, that's what they required. And it kind of made sense because once you get to Kleinfeld, it's actually much smaller than you think it's going to be. On the show, of course, with the camera angles and everything, they're making it seem massive. And don't get me wrong, it's big, but it is not the massive place that you think it is when you see the show. So in reality, if everybody there having a consultation had like an army of 7 or 8 people, you would have no place to walk around because there would just be people everywhere. So I get why they limited it, but again, it was kind of a bummer. So a lot of people ask me, in reality, how many dresses do you try on? Because they only show so many on the show. And I think I tried on maybe like 6 or 7. It's been a couple years since I've been, so trying to remember back. But I could have tried on more if I wanted to. The look that I was going for was so specific that there weren't more dresses that really fit in the category of what I was wanting. And the time that you're there, I mean, we were literally there all day filming and trying on dresses. So I don't think I would have wanted to extend that out any further and try on any more dresses. I'm interrupting myself to bring you this week's sponsor. This video is sponsored by the Bride Babe Club. Don't have a wedding planner? I got you, babe. Join the Bride Babe Club, where you have access to me, Rachel Burt Garcia, luxury wedding and celebrity party planner. By joining my club, you're gonna get community with other bride babes, weekly wedding planning tips from me personally, live streams with me where you can ask me anything about your wedding in real time, access to me via direct message to ask me anything about your wedding planning, and tons of giveaways, including a monthly cash giveaway every month to a randomly selected member that you can put towards your wedding planning budget. And so much more. The best part about it is it's only $19.99 a month, a taste of wedding planning luxury at a price that everyone can afford. So ditch the wedding planning stress and join the oh-so-exclusive Bride Babe Club. See you on the inside. And now back to the video. Another misconception is that so many of my friends and family think that I got paid to do this and think that I got paid to go and flights reimbursed and hotel stay reimbursed, and that is not the case. So when you go to Kleinfeld for Say Yes to the Dress, I mean, you are on your own dime. At least that's how it was when I did the show. Although once you're there and if you pick a dress, they are really great about working with you on your budget, and as far as my experience, giving you a discount on your gown. I don't know if that was because of the show or how they always work, but they were really great about giving me a good deal on my dress. Funny enough, so many people ask me if the camera crew goes in the dressing room with you. And the answer is yes and no. Yes, in the sense that there are certain scenes that are filmed inside the dressing room. I mean, you're completely covered up. They give you this cute little robe to put on. And of course I brought, you know, slip and Spanx and all the good stuff. So you're covered up the whole time. But there are certain scenes where they come into the dressing room with you to get your initial reactions on things and just to kind of film in that environment with all the mirrors around you and everything like that. But it was never a point where you're uncomfortable. So many people ask me if I felt pressured to buy a dress. And honestly, it's kind of intimidating when after every dress you try on, they're standing there going, you know, okay, is this the one? Are you going to say yes to this dress? And it's definitely a little nerve-wracking, but they were so great about talking me through the whole process, and just they were so down to earth and so sweet with me that at the end of the day, I knew that if I didn't buy a dress, it was gonna be totally fine. So my consultant was Ellie, and then of course, Randy was there helping as well. Now, I'm super lucky that that was the case, because that's not always the case, and I didn't get to pick my consultant, but if I had gotten a pick, I definitely would have chosen Ellie anyway, and I'm so glad that Randy was there to help me through as well. And of course, the question that I get asked most often is, what about Randy? What is he like in real life? And he is exactly like he is on camera, just so nice, so fun, so over the top. Of course, like we all do, we turn it on a little bit more for the cameras when the cameras are rolling, but he is just genuine and got my vision like that and just beelined it for the exact dresses that I knew that I would like. He just got my vision and he heard everything that I was wanting, and he himself personally picked out the dress that I ended up buying for my reception gown. So of course, I said yes to the dress, but it's a little more complex than that. So I definitely suggest watching the video. I'll actually link it below. Not only my Say Yes to the Dress YouTube video, but also the episode itself, which is season 14, episode 16, called Not Afraid to Try New Things, for a little surprise ending that goes a little further beyond just me saying yes to the dress. So you would think once you find the dress, you know, you buy it, you pack it up, you get to leave. But when you're on the show, actually, that's when the real work begins, and you're there doing interviews, and your family members and friends that you brought are doing interviews, and it's just a much longer process than you would think after the fact, that I think is a little known fact about behind the scenes of filming of Say Yes to the Dress that you don't really see, is how long it truly takes to film that episode. A lot of people also ask me if I flew back to get my alterations done. And the answer is no, I didn't. Part of me wishes that I would have. I just didn't honestly have time. I purchased that gown from Kleinfeld so tight in to my wedding day that with everything else that I had going on, I really didn't have time to go back. So I did get my alterations done here in Dallas. But I think it would have been a really fun element to go back to, for my alterations and get that piece filmed as well. So another thing that you've probably seen if you follow me is that my episode actually aired prior to my wedding. And a lot of people ask me if this is common, and as far as I know, it's not. I only know of one other bride, their episode aired before their wedding day. And I think they actually sued the network or were going to pursue legal action and lost, because you signed so much paperwork prior to going on the show. So for me, that thought never even crossed my mind. I mean, I just threw a party about it. So I decided to have a dress reveal party where we did like a little rooftop champagne and cupcake situation. And I had all my friends and family that attended, you know, guess if I said yes to the dress, and if so, what was the designer? So it turned out to be just an even more fun memory that went along with my wedding planning journey. So it just turned out to be a really fun part of my wedding planning journey. So I was kind of able to turn that negative into a positive. Overall, the experience was so much fun and I'm so glad I did it. I am beyond grateful that I got cast for the show, and I had a great time and I made some great connections, and I had a beautiful reception gown. So I'm super grateful and thankful that I got to be a part of it. Thank you so much for sticking with me through this video. If you like this video, definitely consider watching my other YouTube video about my Say Yes to the Dress experience, linked down in the description box below. Also, I will link the full Say Yes to the Dress episode in the description box below, so definitely go check that out too. Thank you so much for liking, commenting, and subscribing. Follow us on Instagram at asyouwish_DFW. And if you want a little bit more about my personal life, at Rachel Burt Garcia. My TikTok is the same as well. Thanks so much, and until next time, bye babes.